I'm Vin.
I'm sorry.
And I know you just hung out with us earlier today, and then
we missed you.
We missed you. Yeah, in the Matrix Part 3, we said, Mr. Anderson, welcome back. Okay, so here's the deal. We're really, really big on this whole community thing, and we're really, really big on Facebook. So what happened was, Cam and a couple other people, and a bunch of you guys have been recommending, requiring, requesting Devin Townsend. And so, It just piled up on me on Facebook. So finally I said, you know what? Let's do it tonight. I was like, sorry, let's do it tonight. And would you say?
Yes, that's what I've been thinking we should do.
So now we're going to do Devin Townsend. The song is called Kingdom. And I guess this guy is like he has like a ton of side projects and stuff like that. And this is his, I don't really know. I don't have any context, but we got the lyrics over here. And this is Devin Townsend, and it's a live show, I think it's just him. I don't really know, and I think I'm talking too much. I think I just need to hit play, because Kim is, it's 5 o'clock where she is, and she's waiting up for us, so we need to do this now, okay? So here it is, Devin Townsend performing Kingdom. Let's do it.
Take 3, marker.
Okay, this is not my third take. This is my first take. This is my third take. That would imply that I screwed it up twice before, which I didn't. So, all of you out there in EMG watching land, you know, I'm Devi.
genuinely enjoy this. What in the world? So this is a guy who enjoys his instrument and enjoys performing.
Yeah, I was going to say, he enjoys the people he's performing for, too.
Yeah, yeah. But the lyrics are, like, super interesting. But just the metal was, I feel like you were feeling the metal.
Yeah, I was vibing it. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, we haven't had a lot of, like...
Yeah.
Rhythmic, like chuggy metal recently, because somebody keeps asking for a band that doesn't do like chuggy metal because they're so ethereal. But this was like chuggy.
Yeah, I liked it.
Like, this is rock and roll. But at the same time, you know what's, I feel like this is a guy who, you know how people say stuff like, "Oh, I know you never loved me anyway," and they'll like laugh. And they're saying like really deep stuff,
yes,
and like
stuff that's real.
But they're saying it in sort of like a, that's their little
keep
defense
light,
mechanism.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like if you look at the lyrics that he's saying in this song,
yeah, what he's saying,
they're super deep in this song.
Were the lyrics like not completely here?
I think, "Stay with me, Lord," I think is what he's saying in the chorus. "I'm fine. Stay with me, Lord. Play with me. Stay with me, Lord. Play with me."
Yeah. That's so, interesting.
So he's saying, I wonder why I've come undone. I know I missed it. I missed the point. It seems to me that this song, I could be way off here. Townsend fans help me. But it seems like at some point with his music, he's such a master musician that he missed the point of what music was supposed to be. And he's sort of like lost himself in the middle of all the fame and all
that
stuff.
But he said, if I could change it, I would.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, he could change it. If it's just his music he's talking about, he just...
Well, no, I'm saying he's getting lost in the fame and the stardom and all that stuff.
Oh.
And so,
Really? That's what you think it's about?
Well, what do you think it's about?
I don't know.
He named the song Kingdom. Go ahead.
Yeah, I don't know. "I've seen the way it's headed, down and down the truth descended. Have it here without worry. Baby, please, there is no hurry." I'm confused on some of these lyrics. Like,
well, it seems to me that he says, "Why I've come undone, I've come undone."
Mm-hmm.
And he's saying, "Lord, play with me." Because I think that the way that he connects with God is
through
music.
His instrument.
Through
yeah.
his music. So when he's saying play with me.
Oh,
it's not play with me like a child,
yeah,
but it might
like
be.
Like a mind of a kid. I was thinking play with me like, come, yeah.
It may be because look at his attitude when he's performing. It's kind of childish.
Yeah.
So I think it's a double in the sense of
play with
me as in like, hey, this is who I am. I'm a jokey guy. But also like that childlikeness with him. And he keeps saying, "Lord." Like, look, guys, here's the thing. You don't need to like suggest songs that are like, that have religious undertones.
I know. Yeah.
Um, But I mean, if the song resonates you, whether it's religious or not, send it to us. We'll do it.
Yeah.
But he's saying, "Play with me, Lord." It seems like the way that he connects with God is through his instrument, but also the way that he lost God was through his instrument. Because the fame and all that stuff takes you away.
Okay.
See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And as he says, he's come on down. What's interesting is that he's saying down, it seems like the woman is his, women are his downfall. Because it says, you basically have it here and without worry, baby, please, there is no hurry. You know, like basically she's saying, take your time. And then right here, he says, the truth descended, hell is here. But it hath no fury like this woman still. Meaning, hell hath no fury like a woman scorned.
Yeah, I was going to say, that's different than what I remember it to be.
So it looks like up here, he's with basically a groupie, right? Like, hey, baby, you can have it. Hey, there's no need to rush.
Yeah. You know?
But then down here, it's with his main girl, and she has no wrath because, hell hath no wrath like a woman scorned. And you notice... there's no worry, I'm fine. You know how stereotypically women will say they're fine when they're really not and all that stuff. So I think that that's what's going on. Huh. It's like he's saying that he's lost his way to music.
Oh, that's interesting.
Right? And if he could change, he would. But when you have all that access to all that stuff, it's very, very difficult to change. And so it's kind of separated him from God. And it says, good God, I would if he could change it.
Right.
And then it goes down to his, with the woman, and he's talking about ego. He's talking about his ego, mm-hmm. how the, being this amazing
ego
rock star.
Soul.
Does that, what were you going to say?
Remember that book that you suggested that I was reading that book?
Grapes of Wrath?
Okay, well, remember in the story, there was like this guy that was a pastor, but then like, he would get done preaching, and then he would want to go with the girl, and then he would, and then... After he feels so guilty about it because he wasn't married to her or whatever, and then then he'd go back to preaching. It was like this constant cycle, and it kind of seems like that if your interpretation's correct, then it seems like that, because it's talking about the woman, then he's saying, I'm fine, stay with me, Lord, play with me, stay with me, Lord. Like, he wants God to stay with him, but then he keeps going, like, but then he still wants God to stay with him. Like, there's that kind of back and forthy thing going on, you know?
Yeah, yeah. And ego, it's only a soul. That's a very, very interesting line.
Yeah, I don't understand that one either.
We are the world. We are the hope. We are so happy to sing a song along. You know, like, we are the hope. You know, like rock stars. Like, you know, when you go there and people are like, oh, you changed my life and all this. So it's very, very hard to keep a level head and not be an egomaniacal crazy person when you're the hope of everybody. And everybody's so happy to sing along with all your music. Everybody knows every word that you've written in the backseat of your car, in the back of a book or something. And then boom, you put it in the studio. Now everybody's singing along to what you're saying. How in the world are you supposed to realize that you're only one soul, you're only one person? How can you keep your ego in check?
Wow.
How is that possible?
Yeah.
And this is the conundrum with rock stars, right? It's like we exalt these people.
I know.
And then we go, you're acting like a rock star, when they don't want to sign the 8 millionth autograph. You worship these poor rock stars, and then, these very rich rock stars. You worship them, and then, you tell them that they're egomaniacs because, they don't want to.
They don't do what you want.
They don't do what you want them to do.
Which makes you an egomaniac.
Yeah, exactly. He says, now I see the way I'm headed, down and down, the truth descended. Hell is here, but it hath no fury like this woman. And then he ends the song by saying, stay with me, Lord, play with me. You know, like, I think he's saying that, he never really lost his inner child. Mm-hmm. And his inner child is gets expressed more most fully through his music, through the gift that he's been given.
Why do you think he says, down and down the youth descended?
I think this is a bad lyric. I think it's the truth descended. Because up here it says the truth descended.
Oh, man. Why did you get the bad lyrics?
The truth is dawning on him, basically, is what's happening.
Oh, okay.
Because when you're everybody has that moment when they wake up and they see what's actually going on with their life.
Mm-hmm.
And that's when the truth descends on you.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. Yeah, but it's interesting that, in my mind at least, and he names the song Kingdom, which is right. very interesting. Because it's like, whose kingdom is he building? Is he building his own kingdom or God's kingdom? I don't know what his background is. But it's interesting that he played, the lyrics in the song to me are very, very deep lyrics. But he plays it in this sort of childlike way where it doesn't seem that he's taking it very seriously.
And the faces that he's making.
Yeah.
Stretches his face out at the end like kids do.
Yeah, it's like Riley.
Right.
You know, we've got this friend and he's a little man. And you know, and he's like that. You know,
yeah.
He says really significant stuff. But it's like, nobody loves me, you know, type of thing.
Yeah.
It's the thing about...
wrong. He has our hearts.
Yeah, I mean, I love the kid to death. Shout out to Riley. But... What's interesting to me is that that's a conundrum with rock stars. On the one hand, like, they get stuck. A lot of them do. A lot of them do. Not all of them, but a lot of the rock stars get stuck in, like, this, like, perpetual adolescence. Because you're rich and you have access to everything and it's about nonconformity. And so the rules that all of us as adults have to kind of conform to, like,
no,
you can't,
it's true.
You can't wake up at, you know, 12:30 and be successful in life. They can.
Right.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, their day doesn't start till 6:30, you know, p.m., right? So, like, they get stuck in this adolescence. So I think a lot of these guys are actually very childish at heart.
Well, plus, a lot of the songs kind of have, like, this rebellious overtone to them. You
right.
know what I mean? So if you have to be like, ugh,
yeah, you're,
this, you know what I mean?
You're 45
like,
and you're talking
you
about...
You have to still, like, feel it to be able to sing it with
yeah.
such emotion that you stir the crowd. So you can't mature your... I would assume you can't mature your mind too much beyond that.
I don't know what band sings this song, but it's like, we're not gonna take it. No, we ain't... And they're like 55 or 60 years old still singing this teenage rebellion. Like, you're getting an AARP freaking thing in the mail. Like, you're talking about... You're gonna rebel against your parents. Your parents have been with the Lord for about 50 years, my man. Like, what are you talking about? But I really like the song. I like the back. I'm a sucker for background vocals, man. I
oh,
love
yeah,
like the
yeah,
epic. Like, I'm like, I want to climb a mountain.
Yeah.
You know, and I usually don't like climbing mountains because how many brothers do you see like on mountains? Seriously, that's a serious question.
I've never.
Yeah, we don't do
not
it.
Not a one.
Not gonna be able to do it. So like, you know, but like the it was just like, oh man, I wanna, you know. It was just very, very epic.
Yeah, it was inspiring.
Epic song.
I liked
very
it. Plus
song.
I liked that he was like happy about it and enjoying what he was doing and it like just immediately brought me in. I was like, happy, we can be happy on this one.
Yeah, yeah. We've had a couple
right.
gut punches in the
Yeah, more than a few.
One more thing, though. If you would have heard this song, the studio version, would you have ever imagined that it would be performed like this?
No, not at all. No,
not at
no,
all.
No way.
Yeah.
No, it was good, though. I really liked it. This is one that I'm gonna play this one again when I'm by myself.
Yeah.
I'm really going to feel the lyrics and
we'll
feel
probably,
the music.
We'll probably be playing it when we're editing. Okay, guys. Well, Kim, the rest of the Facebook crew, Danny, yeah, you know, it's a first. I don't think this has ever happened before where
no.
we just did two videos
nope.
like this. We're going to stay on our same schedule, so we will have another video released tomorrow as well. But, you know, it had to happen. If you have a video that you really believe in, get a couple of your friends, gang up together, and create a Facebook thread, and you will bully us into doing it. Also, eventually we're gonna transition to a Facebook group because we only have... There's a 5,000 friend request limit, and we're probably gonna hit that limit pretty soon here.
We don't want to block you guys out.
So we're gonna shoot another video and talk about direction then. Thank you very much for taking the time, and we're gonna go edit now because it's like 5.
We gotta get it out for Kim.
Yeah, it's like 5 in the morning. All right, Vin out.
Story out.
All right, we're gone.